Hello students, I, Mrs. Madhavi Mathre, welcome you all in the next lecture of Mathematics 1. We are revising chapter number 1. That is sets. In that, we have revised up to practice set 1.2. We have seen the meaning of the word set and then we saw the various methods to write set. Afterwards, in the previous lecture, we have discussed about the types of sets, that means singleton set, null set, finite set and infinite set. Also, we saw what is the meaning of equal sets and we have discussed practice set 1.2 based on that. Now, let us go ahead towards the next topic, that is Venn diagrams. Okay. Now we saw two methods of writing the set. Now here, this is one more method to write set. So in this method, the sets are represented by using the figure, any geometric figure like circle, oval shape, triangle, rectangle, square, any geometric shape you can use for representing the set. So such a figure is called as Venn diagram. Okay, the example, see here, you can see that five numbers are there in set A. So all these elements are set A are written within the figure and the name of the set is also written inside the set as a capital alphabet. Okay, so this figure shows us the Venn diagram of set A. Now here, this was discovered by the mathematician called John Venn. Okay, so it is called as Venn diagram. You can see here now one more example is the given. The set is given in the set builder form that B is a set of all X such that minus 10 is greater than or equal to X and is greater than or equal to 0. And X is an integer. So we have to write down all the integers from minus 10 to 0. Okay, so you can write down them anyhow in this figure. Okay, like here they are written in sequence, so it is better, but it is not like that. You can write them anywhere. So all the elements in the set in this way, they are represented by using different figure. Even you can go for a freehand sketch also, you know that, and then you can represent the set. The name of the set you have to write inside. So such representation is called as Venn diagram. Now let's go ahead. Now we will see the important concept of subset. For this, let us take one example here to understand it better. Okay. Suppose A is one set where you have elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. And B is a set where you have elements 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, so here you can see these are natural numbers up to 8 and here we represent even natural numbers from this. Okay, so what we can find here, all the elements of B are present in A. See, 2 is present in B as well as in A. 4 is also present both the places. Similarly, 6 and 8 also. And in addition to that, A contains some extra elements also. Okay, so if we have A and B are as a two sets and every element of set B is also an element of set A, then we say that B is a subset of A. And symbolically we write it like this, smaller set first, then this symbol of subset and then the bigger set. B is a subset of A. Please take a note that A is not a subset of B. The smaller set is a subset of the bigger set. And how we are going to read it? B is a subset of A, or simply you can say B subset A. Now if we want to represent it by using the Venn diagram. Now see, all the elements of B are present in A. That means set B is completely inside A. Okay. Therefore, we can draw the Venn diagram like this. A bigger shape shows us set A and B is completely inside that. So inside here, smaller set is drawn. That is B. So B is subset of A. Then what we have to do is in this smaller part, that means in set B, we will write down all the elements of set B. They are 2, 4, 6 and 8. And the remaining elements from the set A are written here in the remaining space. Okay, or outside B they are written. See all the odd numbers 1, 3, 5 and 7. Now we are not going to repeat these elements again in this space because already they are there in inside. Okay, so, and you know that we have to write down the number of element once only. We cannot repeat. So already this complete part is A and B is totally inside A. So this way we are going to represent it by Venn diagram. Okay. So when every element of set B is an element of set A, then we say that B is a subset of A. Okay. Let us go further. Now we will see some important properties about subset. From that first one, every set is a subset of itself. That is, A is subset of A. Second thing, empty set is a subset of every set. That is, you know that is symbol of empty set called as phi. Phi is subset of A. Then, if A is equal to B, means if two sets are equal, then A is subset of B and B is subset of A. And opposite to that, if they are subsets of each other, then we say that they are equal sets. That means if A is subset of B and B is subset of A, then A is equal to B. So this statement is called as converse of this statement. Okay? Universal set. Okay, so here we have to think of a bigger set always. We have to think of a bigger set, and that set can accommodate many sets under consideration. Then that set is called as universal set. Okay, for example, take the example of books in the library. Books in the library is a universal set, and then you can have various subsets there, like books of drama, books of stories, books of poems and so on. So they are subsets. Okay, so that bigger set is called as what? Universal set. Now let us take one example to understand universal set. Okay, so here a cricket team of 15 students is to be selected from the school. So when we want to select 15 students from the school, then we are going to think of the students from the school, those who play cricket. We are not going to think of all the students because we want to prepare cricket team. So we will think of only the students which play cricket. So that will be the universal set. Say from school, suppose 100 students are playing cricket. So those 100 students is a universal set here, and from that we will select best 15 as a team. Okay, so this way we can say that all the students in the school who play cricket, that is universal set. Now keep in mind, universal set is always represented by the rectangle. When we draw Venn diagram, it is always represented by the rectangle, and that U is written outside, it is not written inside. Okay, so the universal set is denoted by U, and in Venn diagram it is represented by rectangle. Now see here, all the students in the school, those who play cricket, is the universal set, and the team of the cricket players is going to be a subset of that. Okay, now let us go further. The important concept of complement now we will discuss. So this complement of a set is related to universal set. So let us take the example here to understand it better. Okay. So see here, suppose U is the universal set where we have numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. And A is a set having all the even numbers. That means 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. So the complement of A, which is written like this and read as A complement, is equal to the set of all the elements which are present in U but not in A. So the elements which are in A, those elements we are not going to write in A complement. Correct? They are totally different. And when we combine these two, we are going to get universal set. Okay? So if U is an universal set and B is a subset of U, like here A is a subset of U, okay, then the set of all elements in U which are not in B, it is called as what? Complement of B, and denoted by B dash or B, and above that you have to write down C as index. So this denotes as B complement. In rule method we can write down that B complement is a set of all X such that X belongs to U but X does not belong to B. They are totally different. Nothing is common. Such sets are called as disjoint sets. Nothing is common in that. Now if we want to represent the Venn diagram of this, the Venn diagram will be like this. You know, universal set we represent by the rectangle and U is written outside. Now A is subset of U, so A is drawn inside and all the elements of A are written 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Now here the remaining elements, they are written here 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. Now this remaining part, the shaded region, gives us A complement. Okay, no elements are common. You can see that this is white color part and this is shaded region. So nothing is common in them. They are totally different. But A and A dash together, they form U. Okay. Now let us see the properties here and more examples. So properties of complement of set. So the first property here is no elements are common in A and A dash. Just now we have discussed if odd numbers are present in A, then even numbers are present in A dash. Nothing is common. Then A is a subset of U, that means all the elements of A are present in U. Similarly, all the elements of A complement are also present in U, because they both are the subsets of U. So A is subset of U and A complement also is a subset of U. Then next, complement of set U is an empty set. So we can write down here U complement is equal to phi, that is empty set. You need to study these properties because they can be asked in MCQs. Similarly, we can say that complement of empty set is universal set, that means U. Again, these two are called as converse statements of each other. So phi dash, that means complement of empty set is a universal set. So U complement is phi and phi complement is U. Keep this in mind. Now, let us see practice set 1.3. I am not discussing all the sums. Already they are discussed. Now here I will only discuss the sums which are related to these topics. Some were given as homework. I hope you must have done it. Now see the first question here. If A is equal to A, B, C, D and E. B is equal to C, D, E, F. C is equal to the set where we have two elements B and D, and set D contains two elements A and E. Then which of the following statements are true and which are false? Okay, now it is related to the concept of subset. Okay, so here you try to find out that which set is a subset of other. So let us see now here. C is subset of B. So think of the set C and B. See, this is C and this is B. Now here, according to the definition of the subset, all the elements of C should be present in B. Then only this is true. So what we can observe here is C contains element B which is not present in B. So this statement cannot be true. It is a false statement. Correct? Because the element B which is present in C, it is not present in B. So C cannot be a subset of B. So it's a false statement. Now see second, A is subset of D. Okay? See, D is smaller set contains only two elements, and A is very big set containing five elements. We know that always the first set it here is a smaller one, and the next which is appearing after the symbol it is bigger one. But it is exactly opposite. So no, there's no need to check the elements also. Only what we can say here is here we have five elements, but here we have only two. So again, this is a false statement. Now next, D is a subset of B. See, D is smaller, B is bigger. Now let's check for the elements again. So D contains A here, but B does not contain A. So here only we can say that it's a false statement because the element A which is present in D does not belongs to B. Next, D is a subset of A. Now check for D and A. Okay, A is bigger, D is smaller. So now let's check the elements. A is present in D and A is present in A also. E is present here and E is present here also. That means both the elements of set D are present in set A, and therefore we can say that D is a subset of A. That means this is a true statement. Correct? Next, B is a subset of A. Now check for B and A. B is bigger. Sorry, A is bigger, B is smaller. Now let's check for the elements. C is present here also. D is also present. E is also present. But check for F. F is present in B, it is not present in A. So again, it's a false statement. Correct? B is not a subset of A. Finally, the sixth one. C is a subset of A. So check for now C and A. C is smaller, A is bigger. Now let's check the elements. B is present in A. B is present both the places. Similarly, D also is present both the places. That means both the elements of C are present in A. So we can say that C is a subset of A. That therefore it's a true statement. Okay, so this way you are going to check for subset. Okay, now let's go ahead. Question number two. Take the set of natural numbers from 1 to 20 as universal set and show set X and Y using Venn diagram. Now see, question number one contains the set X and question number two contains set Y. Now, when you refer to digest or some solutions, no, sometimes it's found that this question is solved together. That means in one diagram only X and Y are shown, which is wrong. You have to draw the diagram, separate diagram for question number one and separate diagram for question number two. You cannot combine them together and you cannot draw it, okay? So let us see first one, then second one you can do by yourself. What we have to do is we have to take the numbers 1 to 20 as universal set. So you can write down set U like this. U is equal to the set where we have elements 1, 2, 3 and so on up to 20. There's no need to write all the elements here because writing 20 numbers will take time. So instead you can write like this. It is assumed that the numbers which are not written, they are present there. Then we have to write down the first one where we have set X, or X is a set of all X such that X belongs to N, means X is a natural number and X is between 7 and 15. See, 7 is strictly less than X and X is strictly less than 15. That means numbers 7 and 15 are not allowed. So we have to write down the numbers from 8 to 14. Okay. So set X contains the elements 9, 10, 11, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Now we have to draw the Venn diagram. What we can observe is all the elements of set X are present in U. That means X is a subset of U. So universal set we have to draw using rectangle. So you will show the universal set by rectangle. You will write U outside. Then set U X you will draw totally inside U because it is a subset of that. And then write down all the elements of set X here, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14 and the remaining elements from U, that means 1 to 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can write anywhere randomly. And then from 15 remaining elements, so 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, so these are the remaining elements from U, which gives us X dash. This is X and the shaded region gives us X dash, complement of X. And together they form universal set U. Okay, similarly you have to draw for Y also. Again you will write down U, then you will write down the set Y. And Y contains the elements such that Y is a prime number from 1 to 20. So you will write down the prime numbers. You know prime numbers, they start from 2. 1 is neither composite nor prime. So you have to write down all the prime numbers starting from 2 up to 20. And then similar diagram you need to draw for second one. Okay. Question number 3. Here we are provided with set U, means universal set, where we have elements 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. And one more set P is provided where we have elements 1, 3, 7 and 10. What you will find is all the elements of P are present in U. That means P is a subset of U. Now here they have asked us two questions. In the first question they have told us to show the sets U, P and P complement, means P dash, by Venn diagram. And second one is we have to verify that complement of P complement is equal to P. Okay. That means the complement of the complement is the set itself that we have to prove. So first of all, here we have to write down the given things. So we will write down the set U first. So U is equal to the set where we have elements 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Then we will write down set P. We have elements 1, 3, 7 and 10. Now from these, we will write down P dash. Okay. So P dash is a set where we have elements which are present in U but not present in P. So 1 is present in P, we will not write. So we will write then 2. Then 3 is present here, so don't write 3. 7 is present, so don't write 7. Then you have to write 8, 9. Then 10 we don't have to write, and 11 and 12. So this way we have written P complement. Now these three sets we have to show by using Venn diagram. So for universal set U, we will take the rectangle and inside that rectangle we will draw set P, because P is a subset of U. Okay, so the rectangle gives us the universal set and P is totally inside it. So the elements of P we can write here, which are 1, 3, 7 and 10. And the remaining elements, that means the set, the elements which are present in P dash, that we can write here in the remaining portion, which is shaded, so that clearly we can observe P and P dash. See, this is P and this is P dash. Together it gives us universal set. So the remaining elements from U, which are not present in P, that means which are present in P dash, we will write here in the shaded region. So they are 2, 8, 9, 11 and 12. So this way we are going to represent it by Venn diagram. Got it? Now let us see the second one. Verify complement of P complement is P. So here for second one, once again, let us write down U. Then write down P and P complement. Copy all the things here. Because it's a separate question, so you need to write them again. Now here, next thing is we have to find complement of P complement. Okay, so now let us see the sets U and P complement. So we have to write down the set such that the elements are present in U, but they are not present in P dash. Okay. So complement of P complement. So see here, 1 is not present here, so 1 is written from U. Then 2 is present, so we are not going to write 2. Then 3 is written. Correct? then 7 is written. Afterwards 8, 9, they are present, so we don't have to write down them. So afterwards we will write down 10, and then 11, 12 are there, so we will not write them. Now see, observe the set P which is numbered as 1, and observe the set complement of P complement which is numbered as 2. What we will find is they contain exactly the same elements, which are 1, 3, 7 and 10. So from these two statements 1 and 2, we can say that complement of P complement is P itself. Okay, we have proved it. So this is an important property, that complement of complement is the set itself. Okay, now let us go ahead towards the next question. Fourth one. Here we are provided with set A, where we have four elements, 1, 3, 2 and 7, and they have asked us to write any three subsets. It's very easy for you to write down any three subsets. Now here, it is possible for us to write down 16 subsets. How I said 16? Always you have to count number of elements, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and 2 raised to 4. Is 2 raised to number of elements, those many subsets we are going to get here. So 2 raised to 4 is 16. So here we are going to get 16 subsets like this. See, if the very first set is the empty set, we have seen that empty set is the subset of every set. Then we have seen that the set itself is a subset of every set. So first and last we can write down from the property. And remaining you can write down by yourself, like you can have singleton sets, that means the element which contain only one element. So here the singleton set 4 we can write down, see 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then we can write down the set with 2 elements. So such combinations we can write for 6 sets, see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And then we can write down the set with 3 elements. So such 4 sets we can write down. So in this way, in all you can write down 16 sets. Out of that you have to write any 3. Okay, now let's go ahead. So now the next topic is operation on sets, but now if we start, then I cannot finish it. So we will start this topic in the next lecture. Okay, so remaining part of the chapter I will revise in the next lecture. You know that very soon you have your second online assessment, and portion for the same is chapter number 1 and 2. Chapter number 2 is recently taught, that is why I am revising chapter number 1. All of you please go through all the solved examples from the textbook, and also solve all the sums from practice set and problem set, so that you will not face any problem while giving the exam. Okay, you can write all the answers of MCQ correctly. At the same times, you can solve the sums which are asked in attachment. That means you have to solve and then you have to click the image and attach it. Okay, so students, today I am stopping here. We will meet in next lecture. Till that, you stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Thank you, students.